international success coach and noted author, Constance Arnold, delivers life-changing strategies through her own spiritual practices, as well as with best-selling authors and experts she interviews. Think, Believe, and Manifest is specially designed to empower your mind and your words to work for you and to bring about the life you've been dreaming of. And now, here's Constance Arnold.
Well, hello, everyone, and welcome to the Law of Attraction Radio Network. And, of course, I am Constance Arnold, your most gracious host, and today I am broadcasting live from wonderful Atlanta, Georgia. So excited that you've joined me from all over the world today. And guess what? If you are listening to this recording, it is no accident. I know that the Spirit of God has attracted you here, and you are going to hear just that one thing that you've been praying about. Maybe you've been feeling bewildered about, and that one shift, that one idea, that one enlightenment is going to begin to move you in the direction of your dreams. Well, welcome everyone, and especially for my listeners in the U.S., we are celebrating Mother's Day this weekend, and I want to say happy Mother's Day to all of the mothers, and especially to my mom who has made her transition, Pauline Lane. Boy, she was a powerful mother, and she really taught me so many wonderful things. And maybe you're like I am, and biologically you did not birth any children, but I was so reminded by my dog's groomer when she was talking to me about Mother's Day. And I said to her, well, you know, I don't have any children. And then she just quickly said to me, she said, but I'm sure you've mentored and birthed children all over the world. And for a brief moment, I forgot that I mentor and that I coach and that I counsel people all over the world and have helped to raise two young ladies. And so happy Mother's Day, and we are so grateful to you. I believe that the saying, the hand that rocks the cradle rules the world, and you know, we have girl power. So for all of the ladies, all of the mothers, you know, just celebrate who you are. You are awesome. You are phenomenal. And I really want to say a special prayer for all of the mothers in Nigeria whose girls have been kidnapped. I mean, I tell you, my heart just really goes out to them. And so we just want to let you know, I know I have lots of listeners in Nigeria, that we are praying for you. I cannot even begin to imagine, you know, what this experience is like for them. So happy Mother's Day. Well, today I have two wonderful guests. I have one of my clients who's going to share a phenomenal experience about her coaching experience with me in the area of business. And then I have Natalie Ledwell. Natalie is the co-founder of Mind Movies. And you know, Mind Movies is all about, instead of using a vision board, we're now using technology and we're using the computer to really compile what our desires are and really compile a movie. And I mean, she has touched something like 1.3 million people, and it is certainly a tool that I really celebrate, and I really, really refer a lot of my clients to use it. Well, let's get started. I have so much I want to talk to you about today. Well, I have one of my clients on the line with me. Her name is Linda, and Linda is all the way from Iowa, and I don't know anybody in Iowa, and she has a phenomenal experience and a phenomenal testimony she wants to share with you. So, Linda, welcome to the Law of Attraction Radio Network.
Good morning, Constance. Thank you very much.
Well, Linda, like I said, I don't know anybody in Iowa, and so tell our listeners just a little bit about who you are.
Well, yeah, my name is Linda. I'm married. We have two sons and two lovely daughter-in-laws and six grandkids, and I work from home. I'm an independent distributor with a direct sales company, which sells world-class nutrition products, weight loss, energy, and sports performance products.
Yeah, and I had the opportunity to meet you a couple of weekends ago in person, and man, she's a baby boomer, but she's really rocking it, aren't you, Linda? She's a size 2 and healthy and vibrant and, you know, just really, really awesome. So, Linda, share with our listeners, how in the world did you find me?
Well, that's a funny story. I was searching for an author on the internet so that I could download an audiobook and listen to it while my mother and I were driving out of town. And it just so happened that that particular author that I had been searching for was a guest speaker on your radio show. And so your name came up with a paragraph about your radio show. So that sounded like something that I'd be interested in, and I clicked on that link and saved it to a podcast. And I'm very technically challenged, so I was really impressed that I even managed to do that. But the funny part about that story is that because I don't know what I'm doing on that, my mother and I, we listened to that same podcast over and over and over again, like 8 times while we were on that drive that day. It just kept looping back again, and we didn't know how to stop it. So we really got to know you well, and just we loved it. And so the next day, I called your office to get some more information, mm-hmm. and to my surprise, you answered the phone.
Right. And I sometimes do that if mm-hmm. I can. And so I just think that's just a prime example of how when you are searching for something, God will really lead you and direct you, you know, to the right person. And so why in the world did you reach out for coaching? I know that you've been doing your business since 1999, and sometimes people just try to do business by themselves, but I personally, I don't believe that that works. So why did you feel like you needed coaching?
Well, that's right. I was a very happy product user, mm-hmm. but I just didn't feel like my business was growing to where I wanted it to be. And I knew that I wanted to be able to help my team reach their goals, and I felt like we all knew what we needed to do. We just weren't quite getting there. So that's why I reached out to you to see, you know, if you could help us, you know, with that missing puzzle piece.
Right. So were you frustrated about the growth of your business? What were your feelings around that?
Well, I was a little bit frustrated, but more I just knew that there was just something missing, that we just were missing something. I really was a little bit frustrated, but I knew that it was basically me.
Right. You know, and I know you have such a strong desire to help your team. How many members do you have on your team? Do you have any idea?
Hundreds.
And so, I mean, I just love it. It was just not about you, but you really wanted to help your team. And I tell people all of the time that you really need to get help. One of the main, I'm not going to say mistakes, but one thing that I really feel like that I wish I had done earlier was to get coaching. I was, Linda, sort of the long ranger trying to handle it by myself, brainstorming mm-hmm. by myself. And I had somebody tell me the other day, they said, you know, I feel like I'm weak if I don't do it by myself. You know, where conversely, really, when you come together, there's such power in synergy and brainstorming. And, you know, that's what you did. So we've been coaching for a while. So how has coaching helped you? Kind of what have we done? What are some things that have stood out with you?
Yeah. Well, one of the things that we worked on was setting goals. We set some short-term goals, like what are you going to do in the next couple of weeks, and then goals for the next 90 days. So we looked out a little bit ahead. And then we also talked about long-term goals as well.
Right. And that's really important.
Right,
really
right.
Get an idea about what you want. Go ahead.
Right. Well, there are several benefits to direct selling, and one is that you get to work from home and set your own hours, but that also means that it's very easy to get distracted. So one of the other things that was very helpful is that we also discussed distractions and how they can keep you from reaching your goals. So we
what were some of your distractions, Linda?
Well, like, you know, I have 6 grandkids, and so you know, I just love spending time with my grandkids. Mm-hmm. And so I want to go to every single baseball game, every single recital. I want to do all of those things. And then the other things, other than family, which, you know, I love attending all that stuff. So that is a high priority for me. But the other thing that distracts me is, like, when I'm at home, oh, my, I better get the laundry done today. Oh, gosh, you know, got to get up and, you know, get the dishes done and then go mow the yard. And, you know, so you've got all kinds of things that you can putz around the house and do. And before you know it, your day has gone by and you haven't done anything productive for your business.
Right. And what we did was, you know, we talked about working in 30, 60, 90-minute segments where you do that and then don't allow any other distractions to really come in. So, you know, I know how much you love your family. And so what about being organized? I know one thing that we really worked on was helping you to organize your life, your business, and your office.
Well, that's another thing that, you know, you helped me to see the importance of being organized, and that if you're not organized, it's the biggest time stealer. So I just made it a point to, you know, make a to-do list and get myself organized so that I knew what I was going to do every day. So when I had to go out and run errands, I organized my path so that I didn't go over here and turn around and go back over here and then run right by that store. You know, so I just organized myself so that I ran those errands in an efficient time. And the same thing in little projects that I needed to do. If I had to organize an event, I broke it down into little segments, like you said, and prioritized what I needed to do first and what I needed to do second. So working through those issues was really proved out to be very helpful for me.
Right, and thank you for sharing that, because a lot of people who work from home, I mean, it's so easy to be distracted. And, you know, and I work from home, and I understand that. So, Linda, what practices or what principles have I shared with you in coaching that have really helped you, not only personally, but in your business? I know we talked about goal setting.
Right. Goal setting was a big one. And one of the things that I did for goal setting, because that was one of the first practices that I really needed to put into place, was to set goals. One of my goals is to buy a new house. Mm. And so what I did so I could visually see how close I was to getting to my goal is I printed a picture of a house that I would love to buy. And then I cut it into several pieces like a puzzle. And every time I met my two-week goal, I would tape a piece of that puzzle together. And so I'm down to where I only have three pieces till my house is complete. And then my husband and I are going to go house shopping.
Woohoo! That is so exciting. And you know, that's just a great tool. Hey, I might use that one myself. And anybody who's listening on, you know, on this recording, you know, that's just a great idea to really keep you motivated, intentional, and focused. And so what about accountability and action? You know, I am pretty big on being accountable.
Right. Well, you know, when you're the owner of your own business, you're the boss. And so you don't report to anybody, and you also don't get a performance appraisal. So accountability also proved to be big for me. And, you know, when you and I had our next appointment, I knew that we would be talking about the previous goals that we had set. So it made me step up and get into action. So, you know, I try to find an accountability partner, like my sister, you know, mm-hmm. her and I work very closely together. And so, you know, she knows what my goals are and what I'm trying to do, and I know what hers are. And so we help keep each other accountable in our business like that. So I think that accountability is huge.
Right. And once again, when you do work from home, when you are the business owner, you need someone else to really be accountable to. And I didn't harass you, but some of my clients I do. You know, what are you doing? I haven't heard from you. You know, mm-hmm. what's going on? And I know personally that there was a lot of personal development that went on between us in the coaching sessions.
Right. Yeah, personal development was huge also. And what I do is, every single day, I pick my grandkids up from school. Mm-hmm. And so what I started to do was I would take a personal development book and put it in my car. And every day I would get to school 20 to 30 minutes before the kids got out of school so that, number one, I could get a good parking spot in line. But number two, I took that 20 to 30 minutes to read from whatever book I was reading at that time. So I had that nice, quiet time to just sit in the car and read. And that proved to be very, very good use of my time.
So true. And then, you know, you were so impressed by my individual coaching that you hired me to work with your team. And tell listeners, how did that go?
Right. Well, my sister and I, you know, our goal was to really help our team reach their goals. And so we asked you if there was something that you could do to help our whole entire team. So you put together a plan where we had several of our team members join us for a webinar once a month for 3 months. And you focused on those three key areas: accountability, action, and achievement. And what that did was that shared with our team the importance of accountability. And when people, you know, you are accountable and people know what you're doing, you seem to be more productive. You know, your productivity increases. Yep. And then action, you focused on being more disciplined and getting more organized and making a list of what you want to do the next day before you go to bed that night. And then also, you highlighted spending time each day on productive activities like talking to people about our product and about our financial opportunity. And then the third thing that you really focused on was achievement, because ultimately we're accountable for our own business.
So true.
And yep, and if we take action, then we're going to achieve a higher level of leadership, which is what we are all striving for. So it proved out to be one of the best things that we did for our team, because our team has really stepped up and they put those things into place that you presented to them over those 3 months, and they have really reached higher levels in their business as a result of that. So we could not be more pleased with that team effort.
And I just love your team. I feel like I know them. I did 3 webinars for you, and I'm so excited, you know, about the increase and the expansion, not only in your business but in theirs. And this is a great principle. When you help people get what they want, then God gives you what you desire. And that's what you've done, because you love your, you know, your team members just passionately.
Yep.
Right.
That's right.
And, you know, and then just lastly, so what would you say to someone, you know, maybe they're in business, maybe they own their own business, you know, maybe they're in direct sales. What would you say to someone about coaching with me as far as me helping them to become a partner with them to help move their business and increase sales and customer contact, et cetera?
Well, I would say, you know, if you have a desire to reach your potential and take your career to a higher level, then Constance is perfect for you. She has the ability to communicate effectively. I would say that she also asks questions and listens to help you see what action steps you need to take. And she sees the potential in others and can take a person from where they are to where they want to be. And I also really feel like she adds value to your life as a person. And the last thing that I would say to them is that the investment is definitely worth it, and I would highly recommend her.
Thank you, Linda. I appreciate that. And, you know, the joke I always have with Linda is, I don't know anybody from Iowa, but, you know, you guys are really rocking it out there in that area and really making things happen. And, you know, I really, you guys sent me a sample of some of your nutritional products, and I was very impressed by it. And when I met Linda, she looked so young, so vibrant. She and her sister-in-law, and, you know, like I said, she's a size 2. She exercises with her mom. How old is your mom, Linda?
She's 79.
Her mom, she and her mom, they exercise like 3 times a week, right?
Yep.
Right.
Yep.
And so her products are really awesome. So if you are interested in more energy, losing weight, and, you know, nutrition, and any other sports performance products, just contact me. And, you know, if I recommend something, that I really believe in it. And so, Linda, I just appreciate you coming on today, really sharing, you know, your heart with the world. So what are you going to do for Mother's Day?
Well, we're getting together, all of us, our families, are getting together with our mother, and we're going to have lunch with her tomorrow after we go to church. So it's going to be a wonderful day.
Well, thank you so much for sharing with everybody listening. We're going to go to a quick commercial, and then I'm going to be back, and we're going to be talking to Miss Natalie Ledwell, and we're going to be talking about mind movies. I'll be right back.
You're listening to Law of Attraction Radio Network, enhancing the well-being of millions of listeners worldwide. LOARadionetwork.com is heard through 25 different internet radio stations, as well as iTunes Radio, Stitcher.com, and our mobile apps. The Law of Attraction Radio Network, your trusted source of daily inspiration at LOARadionetwork.com.
Well, I am back, and I hope that you enjoyed that wonderful testimonial, and so excited about my show today. My very special guest is Miss Natalie Ledwell. She is a best-selling author. She's the author of Never in Your Wildest Dreams, and of course, you know, I love that title. She is a speaker. She's the inspiration show host and co-founder of the Mind Movies. Natalie and her team have reached over 1.2 million people around the globe, helping, assisting, and empowering them to use the same success principles that she used when she was really in a difficult financial situation. 120K worth of credit card debt. Can anybody relate to that? And she built a multi-million dollar company in 4 short years during the worst world economic crisis we've seen probably in our lifetime. And just recently, Natalie recorded her journey about how she lost a large amount of weight. And I saw her and I met her at the Law of Attraction Conference. And I was very moved by her, very moved by her spirit, very moved by her expertise, and just wanted to share who she is to the world tonight. So, Natalie Ledwell, welcome to the Law of Attraction Radio Network.
Hi, Constance. It's an absolute pleasure to be here, and I can't wait to share some wisdom with you and your listeners.
Well, great. Well, for someone who's been under a rock, Natalie, tell our listeners about who you are.
Right. Well, I am, as you said, one of the founders of Mind Movies, and a Mind Movie, for those who are not familiar with that, is actually a movie version of a vision board. So I really help people get clear about what it is that they want, and then to be able to articulate that in affirmations so that they can create this little movie, which is like a visualization cheating tool. Now, we know that with the Law of Attraction, how important it is to not only be able to see this new reality that we want to create in our mind, but we really need to feel those emotions of that as well. And so when you can create a little movie that has your affirmations and then photos that enhance those affirmations, and then you add to that a song or a piece of music or something that really, really moves you, and you combine the three of those elements together, you have a very, very powerful tool to help you visualize this amazing new life. So as you can probably tell, I am from Texas. Actually, I'm from Sydney, Australia, and how I got into this whole business is purely by accident, by serendipitous events, and absolutely by Law of Attraction. Because when I remember having this monumental moment of frustration back in 2006, thinking, you know, I'm missing some vital piece of information here, because my husband and I had 4 businesses. I'd been a student of personal development since I was 21 years old, and we were still slipping back financially, and I had been reading the books and going to the seminars and thinking I was doing everything right. And then along came a little movie called The Secret, which really explained to me the Law of Attraction in a way that I understood for the first time. And then not long after that, a friend showed me this little movie that he had created, And then not long after that, he came to Glenn and I, my husband and I, and said, look, I'd really like to set up a website so people around the world can make these movies for themselves. And it was interesting because at the time, I hadn't even heard of YouTube. I knew nothing about the internet. And my husband would do the banking, but I would have to turn the computer on and log him in for him to be able to do that. So we knew nothing about the internet, but we did understand the power of these little movies. Within a few short years, we were able to come over here to the US. We joined a mastermind group. We surrounded ourselves with people that could really help us launch My Movies to the world. And so by September 2008, the week that the economic crisis hit, happened to be the week that we planned our initial launch of My Movies. And we were so committed to launching this idea to the world that we had were over here with no money, so we were living on credit cards. And by the time the launch morning had happened or started, we were actually $120,000 worth of credit card debt. And that was on top of our mortgage and car repayments and everything else that we had at home. So the pressure was on. And little did we know that the whole world had gone crazy and turned upside down because the economic crisis had hit the planet. So we were fortunate in that we had a very successful week. Our community grew from 8,000 to 80,000 in our pre-launch week. And we did a $700,000 week, the week of our launch. So it set us up for what we have now. Even though everything was working against us, we were able to do that. And now we've built this massive community. We have over 600,000 in our community at the moment. And, you know, I think we're up to about 1.3 million people around the world, and we've just scratched the surface.
Right. So, Natalie, were you praying for something to happen? Were you brainstorming about, you know, Spirit, send me an idea? Or did you feel overwhelmed by the financial debt that you guys were in? Why do you think that happened to you and your husband?
You know, when I saw the movie The Secret, one of the businesses, I mentioned Glenn and I had four businesses. One of those businesses was a network marketing business. It was actually the first time we'd been introduced to that type of business model. And for the first time, because we'd had 10 years of what I call my beige years, which I call them beige because beige is just such a nothing color. But we had 10 years of all these different types of businesses. Nothing was spiritually fulfilling, and we had varying degrees of success. But there was no challenge. It was just like we were just meandering along. And everything was like a brick and mortar type of business. So it's like if we didn't turn up and put in the work, then we didn't get paid. And so when we saw this network marketing model, I created all these affirmations for that business after we saw The Secret. So I was, you know, saying how I wanted to help people around the world. I wanted to travel. I wanted to speak on stage. I wanted to do something that I felt passionate about. I wanted to be financially free, you know, all these type of things. And I was convinced the network marketing business would have been was the vehicle that was going to get us there. And if 2 weeks before our friend approached us with the idea of setting up the website, someone had told me that I was going to live in the US and hang out with my mentors and my heroes and have this life where I was positively influencing people around the world to live a life of their wildest dreams, and I was going to do it through the internet, I would have laughed at them because I just didn't think that was going to be the case because I knew nothing about the internet. Now, the thing is, I think everything happens for a reason. And when I look at that 10-year period, I mean, I think there's a business skill or a human experience or something that I've picked up from every single one of those businesses that contribute to the success of My Movies. And if we hadn't have gone through that experience, we wouldn't have recognized My Movies for the opportunity that it was, and we wouldn't have been able to capitalize on it. And even with that network marketing business, even though it wasn't the vehicle that in the end created the life for us, it was through that network marketing business that we met our friend that showed us the My Movies and actually showed us how, and convinced us to set up the website with him. So it was my intention that I wanted to create a successful business where I could, you know, be financially free and help people. I think that's where a very important part and one of the biggest takeaways I got from the movie The Secret is that you can't be married to how it's going to happen because how it happens normally surprises you, and you don't need to know the whole plan because there are so many things that fell into place for us to be able to create this amazing life for ourselves that I could never have planned for in a million years. And, you know, the reason they came to fruition for me is because I had my eye on the end prize. the successful business and the life that I wanted to create.
So talk about visualization and how we can use visualization to overcome those nasty little limiting beliefs.
Those nasty limiting beliefs, those little gremlins that we have. Yes, you know, and what's really interesting is that I find that even though, like, I've cleared, especially ones around money that I've definitely cleared and had personal experience with that, every time I have go into a new experience in my life, I realize there's other programming. So it seems to be following me the whole time. But, you know, when it comes to visualization, the reason it is so important and such an important part and piece of the law of attraction is that we need to reprogram our subconscious mind to believe that this new visualization or this new reality that we see in our mind actually is our current reality. Because the more that we can convince and program our subconscious mind to think that, the more that it goes, okay, well, it doesn't really know the difference between what we see in our mind and what we see with our eyes. And if you sort of are into any kind of quantum science, it's I'm just reading an amazing book at the moment called Quantum Think. And it talks about how our mind is in our brain, but our mind is like part of collective consciousness. And what our reality that we have is what we create in our mind first, which is really interesting. So if we can quite vividly visualize and see in our mind, you know, this new reality repetitively, what happens is that we start to change our thought processes. So rather than having these negative thoughts that have been in our mind for 40 years in some cases, you know, and they have these specific neural pathways. So every time we think something about money or relationships or health, we have a certain, you know, broken CD that's playing over and over in our mind. Well, when we can do these visualizations, what we're doing is creating new thoughts and new neural pathways, and these thoughts are in alignment with this reality that we keep seeing in our mind. And when we change our thoughts, what happens, that starts to change our actions. And when our thoughts and actions are in alignment with this reality that we keep playing in our mind, this visualization that we see, we start to resonate or vibrate at a certain frequency out into the universe or out into the quantum field or whatever you'd like to call that. Now, when that happens, by law, those things that are a vibrational match to the frequency that we're sending out then are attracted back to us. And that's how the law of attraction works. So, you know, all those chance meetings and golden opportunities and brilliant ideas that help us to achieve this reality that we want are then attracted back to us through the universe or through the quantum field. So the more often we can trick our mind into thinking this you know, new movie or this new reality that we're playing in our mind is our actual reality, the more that we become in alignment with that and be able to manifest that into our reality.
So for people listening all over the world today, Natalie, so that means that they would have to be in a vibrational match for whatever they want to attract.
Yeah. And to be a vibrational match, it just means that that your actions and your thoughts are in alignment with what it is that you want. You know, that's, you know, it's like the be, do, have paradigm or the have, do, be. But most people think that you need to be wealthy, you need to have the money first so that you can, you know, that you can do what you want and to be this wealthy person. But really, you need to act as if you are already wealthy. You need to act as if you're already happy. You need to be happy first. You need to be wealthy first in your actions and your thoughts to create that into your reality. You know, if you're trying to create wealth in your life, but still you are, you know, paying your bills to the last minute, and you're not tipping and you're doing all these things that are really out of alignment with a wealthy person's thoughts and actions, then it's going to be very difficult for you to create wealth into your life. But if you start to act as if you are already wealthy, for example, to get in an abundant vibration, you can do something like as soon as your bills or your invoices come in, pay them straight away. You know, that I do that. As soon as they come in, I pay them straight away because it puts me in that abundant vibration. You know, I always leave a couple of extra quarters in the parking meter, you know, because I always visualize that someone's, you know, maybe hectic and running around and that 25 cents that I've left in the parking meter could really make their day because they could be in a hurry. You know, when I'm tipping at a restaurant, I'll always round up to the next dollar. And all these little things don't cost a lot of money, but they are constantly reminding you that you are abundant, that there is, you know, an abundance of wealth flowing to you, and that you're always acting in alignment with that. And what that does in itself is create more wealth and attract more wealth into your life.
So true. Okay, so Natalie, how can listeners begin to create powerful affirmations? I know a lot of people are using affirmations and they are speaking affirmations, but I hear from people that say, Constance, it's just not working for me. So how can we create powerful affirmations that really change our lives and really bring into our lives what we desire?
You know, I think that for starters, you know, the use of affirmations, I think, is really important. You know, I have quite a few people that say to me, look, I don't feel right. I feel like I'm lying to myself when I say that, when I have an affirmation like I am wealthy when I'm not. So I would prefer to go, you know, I'm in the process of becoming wealthy. I don't particularly agree with that because the purpose of your affirmation is so that you can read it as it's written in present tense, as if it's already happening, and then be able to visualize that. The affirmations are not describing what life is like now. Your affirmations are describing the reality that you want to create. So that's why it's very important that they're written in present tense. You know, of course, start as many with the words I am as you can, because that actually really helps to put you in that, you know, visualization, in that reality. It makes it easier for you to do that. And, you know, the language that we use around our goals is very important. You know, having an affirmation or having a phrase like I am debt free is not really an affirmation, because, you know, when I remember that the affirmations are to create visualizations or pictures in our mind, when I say the word debt, I remember that moment of monumental frustration back in 2006 where I'm thinking I'm missing something here. So it's really important that we talk about and describe what we do want rather than what we don't want. You know?
So true. I love that. You know, and so I love the title of your book, Never in Your Wildest Dreams. Very interesting. And, you know, so many of us have dreams, but, you know, maybe circumstances have sort of squashed our dreams. So what are some of the principles that you share in your book?
Well, it's actually fiction. It's an interesting book in the fact that it is fiction. It's actually a transformational story. Mm-hmm. But at the end of each chapter, the reader goes through to a little video that I created, which is either through the app or online, which is inside the chapter. We actually talk about, you know, what the character's going through, what the life lesson is, and how they can apply that to their life. But my heroine, my main character, her name is Catherine, and she could be any one of us. She's divorced, she's unhappy, she's in a business she hates, she's overweight, and she's just, you know, she has the problems that all of us have at some time in our life. And it's actually her journey of going through and figuring out, you know, who she is, what she stands for, what her core values are, discovering what makes her passionate, you know, and what she or how she figures out, you know, what really blows her hair back, so to speak, and how she follows that, and goes through all the principles. So the book is really all about how, when you're applying things like law of attraction and you're eliminating limiting beliefs and you're figuring out your core values and what you're passionate about and realizing how sometimes your everyday language can be working against you because you're trying to visualize this amazing new future, but then when you're judging other people when you're, you know, gossiping and doing all those type of things, you're actually sending mixed signals out into the universe. And so you're not really in alignment with the reality that you want to create. So, you know, the universe is confused. It's like, well, I don't know what you want.
Right.
Because you're thinking this, but you're saying this, and it doesn't seem to all match up. So it's her journey going through that and realizing how, when, you know, you apply these different principles, and it's not just law of attraction because it's one part of the whole process, but when you apply these success principles, what that looks like in your life you know, and it also is a demonstration, an illustration of how law of attraction works, and some of the examples that are in the story actually are drawn from my real life experience about how these crazy, amazing things can fall into place for you that you, sometimes you just have to go, I had to have manifested that because it is so improbable that happened any other way. And I think as you're applying these principles and moving through life, it's really important that we really stop and acknowledge those moments and really appreciate them and have gratitude for them, because it proves to us, you know, and builds our belief that, you know, God or the universe or source or whatever you'd like to call that entity always has our back and is always working in our favor. And the more that we can remind ourselves of that, the easier it is for us to slide through any challenges and to really create a life that we want that is beyond our wildest dreams.
So true. Well, Natalie, I know at the conference you shared that you had released a lot of weight. So share with our listeners, maybe someone who has been struggling with weight, and how did you release your weight? And I don't like the word lose, because if you lose it, you can get it back. But how did you release your weight, and what was your thinking around that? And how can people who might have been struggling in that area really begin to manifest their ideal body?
Yeah, well, this is actually a really personal story, because all of my 30s had been trying to lose weight. In my 20s, I was an aerobics instructor. I worked in fitness for 11 years, and so I had, you know, an amazing body back then. And then in my 30s, through different, choices and lifestyle and businesses and different things, had started to put on weight. And I'm telling you, I tried everything, different diets, different exercises, fasting, you name it. I had tried it. Nothing was working. My husband and I decided to separate in August of last year. And 3 weeks after that, within 3 weeks of us actually making the decision, he was able to leave San Diego for a few weeks and give me some space so I could kind of get my head around our decision, which was really helpful and I was very grateful for. Within 3 weeks, I had released 20 pounds. Oh. 20 pounds. And it was, to be honest with you, and when I look back and think about, so why did that happen so quickly? And yes, I was exercising, and yes, I was eating better, and I actually stopped drinking alcohol because I was using alcohol to numb the fact that I wasn't happy in my marriage. So, but we're talking about a 3 week period here. So I've actually taken 3 months of having an alcohol free 3 months, and I still didn't lose that amount of weight. And what I realized is that I was really holding on to that weight in a way because I was not happy. I had some issues with my husband that I subconsciously didn't realize until after we'd separated that I was kind of, had some resentments towards him from things that happened early in our marriage. And what I realized is I was actually punishing him with my weight. Mm-hmm. Which you just, sometimes I think, as women, why do we do these things to ourselves? Like, all I was doing was hurting myself, but through not being happy, being unhappy with him, and just having that whole, negative energy that I was holding on to and really just trying to avoid it. I didn't want to think about it, and so I was numbing and avoiding with business and travel and wine and everything else that I had going on. When I was able to release that and realize that's what was really happening, and made the conscious decision that from now on I would move forward in a more conscious way and really make and of course the need wasn't there to punish him anymore. I was able to release it very quickly, and I've actually still been losing weight, and I'm not even trying that hard. It's just that I'm in a very happy state right now. And I think as women, we really need to think about if you are in that situation where you've tried all these different things, a lot of times it's something that's deeper underneath the surface. Taking some time to be contemplative and to maybe meditate or walk in nature or whatever we do to have that soul connection with ourselves you know, really ask ourselves, you know, what's happening here and what's underneath all of this, because I never did that.
Wow,
I never took the time to really ask the question. And when I finally did, you know, I was able to release it fairly easily.
Thank you for your honesty and vulnerability. So for anyone who's, you know, might be in a relationship where they are very unhappy, or it is emotionally draining, or they feel that it's just not their highest good at this time, what would you recommend for them?
You know, and it doesn't have to be a relationship. I mean, in my situation, it was a relationship. Mm-hmm. It could be that you're in a job that
so
you don't
true.
Like. There could be someone, you know, you could have a job that you love, but there could be someone who's toxic in your work environment that's really, you know, having that negative effect on you. I think, first of all, we need to remind ourselves that, you know, that God always has our back. And for me, I actually look at it as a gift and a learning experience. From now on, I've made a point of making sure that I have time every single day to have that connection to my spiritual self or to that source energy. You know, I remember seeing a video and Sandy, the woman that works at Facebook, she was interviewing Oprah for a change, and they were all talking about the new OWN network, and Oprah was saying how she's made it mandatory for every single person that works at the OWN network to take 20 minutes every day, and she said, we call it quiet time. She goes, we were calling it meditation, but we've just changed it to quiet time. She goes, and it's a time, 20 minutes, where they have to just disconnect from the busyness of our lives. So, because I think, especially as women, we are always got something on the go. We've got the kids, we've got the husband, we've got the business, we've got the whatever, we're running around. We never really take the time, and it only has to be 20 minutes a day to sit in that reflective state. And when you can be in that reflective state and be in that meditation and then ask the question, whether the question is, what do I need to do to move myself closer to my goals? You know, how do I create more time freedom for myself? You know, what is underlying with this weight that I'm carrying? Why am I carrying this weight? You know, if you ask a question like that and just sit in quiet for a while and wait for the answer to come to you, you will be amazed at the insight that you can have. And the other thing that I really think that we don't do as much as women as we should do is really trust our intuition.
So true.
You know, actually tapping into that, which you can do in those quiet times, and really listening to our intuition. You know, those universal nudges that we get, that a lot of the times we're too busy to stop and hear it. And then other times it's just like we don't know how to trust it. And so we kind of ignore it. And then after a while, it gets to a point where something will happen where you can't ignore it any longer. So really taking that time to have that deep connection every single day, I think, is very, very important.
So true. And I appreciate your sharing, honestly, Natalie. You know, interestingly enough, I've been a therapist for 25 years. And when I met you and I looked into your eyes, I sensed that you were happy. I mean, I just, you know how they say that the eyes are the windows of your soul.
Yeah.
And, you know, and I spoke to you briefly, so I just really appreciate you sharing that. So right now, okay, let's just say people have some difficult circumstances. I heard you talk about gratitude. So if you're in a tough place right now, or maybe your circumstances just do not reflect what you desire, talk about the power of gratitude and what does that look like?
Gratitude, again, is one of those things that needs to be a daily habit. I actually recommend for people that I work with that they write down 5 things every day that they're grateful for. It has to be 5 new things every day. So once you work through the big stuff, like I'm grateful for my family and my house and the fact that I've got clean running water and all the big things, getting in the habit of actually articulating and writing down 5 things every day that you're grateful for makes you appreciate the small things that happen throughout your day that are working in your favor. it could be that, you know, you got fast service at Starbucks that morning and the girl behind the counter was really friendly and really nice and she brightened your morning. You know, it could be that, you know, you received the phone call that you'd been waiting for and you were so grateful that it came in on time. It could be anything, but anything that, you know, that is working in your favor. So having that state of gratitude and being in that state of gratitude for as long as we possibly can is really putting us into a positive vibration. You know, I know the week after Glenn and I had come to the decision to separate, you know, obviously I was very upset and very sad that it was over. And so I was doing anything I could to get myself into a more positive vibration, because before you can even think about, you know, the direction you want your life to go or the reality that you want to create, you have to be in a positive vibration first. So I'd go out for long walks on the beach and I'd go for like 2 hours just so that I was in, you know, a great environment. So I had that you know, that positive input. And then I would start to focus on what I was grateful for the separation. Mm. And even though it hurt and it was upsetting at the time, you know, I started focusing on little things. Like I remember being grateful that I could eat Indian food now because Glenn never liked Indian food. And, you know, I would start out with really silly, stupid things. But it was like the more that you focus on that, the more that expands. You know, and I also think it's an important part of this process to be grateful for the things that are about to come into your life as well. Because when you can surround those future events with gratitude, it's like you're saying to yourself and to your subconscious mind and to the universe, it's a done deal. The box is already ticked. It's already on its way. It's not materialized right now, but I know it's happening. And by being in that gratitude for the future event, it's like you're letting go and you're allowing whatever, however that unfolds for you to happen. So you haven't got that, you know, that desperation and that negative energy around it. You're just releasing it because you're grateful for the fact that it is actually going to happen. It's like you surround it with a vibration of expectancy. Like you just expect it, you know it's going to happen.
So in your life right now, and for listeners all over the world today, do you have a new intention for your life, you know, being single again? And for maybe for a listener out there, how important is it to just set that intention and the power of focusing in only on that?
You know, it's interesting. I feel like I am stepping into a whole new, amazing, exciting chapter of my life. I never thought I would be single at 45. I didn't think that was ever going to happen. But now that I am faced with that situation, it's like, well, you know, what is the gift in this? And I think for every situation that happens, if we can choose to look at the what is the gift, you know, and I'm thinking, well, now I'm 45. Like, I'm not this young 25-year-old who's still trying to figure out who she is and, you know, I know who I am now, you know, and I'm using this time to really step more into that. I'm really doing a lot of inner work to, you know, because like I was saying before, I actually had an experience where I released my limiting beliefs around money in the beginning of 2008 before we had that big successful launch. But I can actually see when I look back at my marriage how some of my past programming was contributing to the demise of our marriage as well. So, you know, I'm looking at working on that too. So I'm working on, you know, being the best version of myself that I can be, because I truly believe that we all have the same purpose, and that is to be the best version of ourselves that we can possibly be and to make a contribution. Our mission and how that plays out for us is always different for different people. But so now it's like I really want to focus on being the best version of me that I can and working through those programs and releasing them from my life and you know, having this fresh new slate. I'm also working on a new generation Mind Movies for Young Bright Minds. And I've done like the kids version of our Mind Movies platform. And I'm really looking forward to, you know, being able to share these success principles with children and with young adults and young people, so that they can all step into the best version of themselves. You know, I think that our younger generation, the kids that are coming through these days, you know, they understand this information way more than we could have ever comprehended it at when we were that age.
Right.
And I'm really excited to be able to influence them to be able to think about how they can make a contribution and how they can take control of their lives and influence the relationships that they have and, you know, and really step into the best version of themselves.
So, Natalie, how can people find out more information about Mind Movies? How can they purchase it, et cetera?
Well, you can, if you go to mindmovies.com, so it's MindMovies, so mindmovies.com, you'll find everything there. You can actually download 6 pre-made Mind Movies for free, so you can actually start watching these movies and get into that vibrational match of, you know, creating wealth or health or spirituality or, you know, family relationships. You can also get access to the inspiration show there. I do 2 shows a week in video of amazing either gurus in our industry or ordinary people who have overcome extraordinary obstacles in their life to create, you know, and to have a really inspiring story. And then you can also find out about Mind Movies and all the other amazing goodies that we have there. So we have a lot of free stuff on the site, and then we also have all the information about Mind Movies as well.
So in closing today, what would you like to leave with people? What inspiration, what word of wisdom would you like to leave with people tonight?
You know, our mind can create the reality that we want. You know, we have the ability to be able to influence the outcomes in our life and to be able to create the version of our life that we want to live through conceptualizing, thinking about it first, and then being able to visualize that on a regular basis. So I really implore you that if you haven't taken the time yet to really sit down and think about what is it that you really want. Because if you were to ask yourself the question, if I had $1 million and I knew I couldn't fail, what do I really want? And you're able to answer that question, then that is the new reality that you'll be able to create for yourself. And that's what I want for you.
Right. Natalie Ledwell, you're a powerful woman, and I'm so grateful that you've been on my show today and to have met you.
Thank you, Constance. It's been an absolute pleasure, and I'm so glad that we got to connect again. And I hope that we connect more in the future.
Right. Well, once again, this is Constance Arnold with the Think, Believe, and Manifest talk show. Thank you so much for joining me. Remember, God loves you, I love you, and the best is yet to come. You better believe it.
Thank you for listening to Think, Believe, and Manifest. Constance will be back next week with another inspirational show. For more information, go to fulfillingyourpurpose.com or send Constance an email at constance@fulfillingyourpurpose.com.